Edgar Cayce was born on March 18, 1877 in the United States. Born into a typical farming family, Cayce told his parents something special when he was about 6 years old. That is, they see many things that others cannot. He also said that he could talk to the relatives of the deceased in the near future. However, Cayce's parents did not pay much attention to his statements. Because it was very common for children of that age to tell such stories in order to attract attention. At an early age, Cayce began to read the Holy Bible with great devotion. As he read the Bible, Cayce began to have amazing faith in God. One day, Cayce took the Bible alone and went to a bush near his house to read the Bible. At that moment, an incredibly beautiful woman appeared before him. That it is possible. At the time, Cayce said he wanted to help people, especially children, but the woman who did not say anything disappeared. Cayce returned home without realizing what had happened, but it was not the old Edgar Cayce. Cayce has never read a book since. He slept with the book he wanted to read under his pillow at night. When he was resurrected, he was able to memorize everything contained in the book. However, Cayce's parents kept the information secret. According to the family's economic status, Cayce was only able to study up to 8th grade. In 1900, Cayce had to face an unfortunate fate. That is, he completely loses his ability to speak. About a year later, however, two occultists completely healed Cayce's with a hypnotic treatment. Accordingly, Cayce began to prescribe treatment to patients who came forward, as well as to patients who corresponded with him. But all of the treatments were announced by Cayce after he fell into a trance. After waking up, Cayce could not remember what he had said in his sleep. The people around him had recorded what he had said. As a result, Cayce became known throughout the United States and around the world as a sleeping prophet. In the 43 years from 1900 to 1944, about 22,000 statements were made in this way, but only 14,000 of them are still left. Cayce said that in addition to being hypnotized, you should avoid asking questions. But some people asked more questions and Cayce answered them correctly. But after waking up from hypnosis, Cayce became very stressed. Because of this, he kept his most trusted companion nearby when he fell into a trance. By 1943, Cayce was in high demand. As a result, he had to fall asleep about 8 times a day. But as we said earlier, Cayce's health deteriorated due to the misconduct of some people. Here, Cayce's subconscious accused Cayce of trying to fall into a trance more than once. He also warned that he could die if he did not limit his daily hypnosis to 2. But as the number of people coming to Cayce for information increased, Cayce was insulted for subconsciously obeying the order. However, he agreed, knowing that his death was imminent. On December 31, 1944, he announced to his relatives that he would die within 4 days. On January 2, 1945, he fell unconscious due to a heart attack. The next day he breathed his last. Prophecy. In 1938, Edgar Cayce stated that man would encounter an underwater shrine near the Bimini Islands, and that this would be the first time that man would encounter part of the continent of Atlantis. And that it meets when it meets. Edgar Cayce's prophecy was not well received at the time. In 1969, however, several divers found parts of a submarine wall near Bimini, an island in the Bahamas. Even today, there is no consensus among archaeologists as to what the building was. In his prophecies, Cayce revealed a great deal about the continent of Atlantis. Cayce explained that the continent was divided into 3 main islands, the Poseidon, the Og, and the Aeons, and that they used a crystal-like material as their source of energy, which led to their destruction. He considered it as one of the reasons. He noted that before the catastrophe, part of the Atlanteans had migrated to Egypt, and that the Great Flood in the Bible is the story of the destruction of the continent of Atlantis. Cayce also predicted the deaths of 2 US presidents in the 1930s. He said one died while in office and the other was killed. Franklin D. Roosevelt died while in office and was shot by an assassin, John F. Kennedy, years ago, showing the truth of Cayce's predictions. Edgar Cayce foresaw the collapse of the Soviet Union, which many believed would never collapse. Cayce told several of the most influential businessmen he had met in 1924 that the American stock market had collapsed in 1929 and that he should be prepared for it now. He also correctly stated that as a result, there will be a severe inflation situation throughout the country. He also stated the year when the country's economic situation will recover again. It was 1933. As Cayce mentioned, these things happened, and the people who lived up to Cayce's predictions overcame this economic challenge. In 1935, Cayce declared that the world would be in conflict for years to come. The Spanish Civil War of that year, Japan's invasion of China, Italy's invasion of Ethiopia, and Joseph Stalin's repressive policies throughout Russia proved Cayce's right. In the same way, Cayce accurately predicted changes near the Earth's pole, Adolf Hitler's rise and fall, the re-emergence of the State of Israel, and working closely with the United States after the collapse of Soviet Russia. According to his predictions, the future of the United States will not be so optimistic. He also predicted that the west coast of the United States, along with the cities of San Francisco and Los Angeles, would be destroyed in the future. Edgar Cayce has said that sea level changes, which even ecologists fear today, will inevitably occur in the future. Those prophecies are far more serious than we can imagine today. According to him, the areas where the Pacific and Atlantic Oceans are located will become landlocked in the future. He said that the Americas and many countries in Europe, which are currently inhabited by humans, would be submerged in the sea. He also prophesied that a new era of mankind would begin after this catastrophic event and that peace and prosperity would prevail throughout the world. We can also get an idea of what the future world will look like in Edgar Cayce's prophecy about his future. Here is a summary of that prophecy. I will born in 2100 in the state of Nebraska. Today the province is surrounded by land, but by then its western boundary will be the sea. Scientists as well as people engaged in spiritual exploration will come to observe me. They will decide to take me to Cayce's place. New York City will be rebuilt after being devastated by an earthquake or a civil war. Almost every home will be made of glass-like material.